The NetSuite Automated Intercompany Management feature allows you to create transactions between subsidiaries so that your subsidiaries can buy from and sell to one another. The Automated Intercompany Management feature also creates elimination journal entries to properly account for these transactions. Let's take a look at how you would set this feature up in your account. First, if you don't already have any elimination subsidiaries, you'll need to create them. Each level of your subsidiary hierarchy can have an elimination subsidiary. These elimination subsidiaries allow you to manage transactions involving two subsidiaries. Journal entries and no other transactions will post to your elimination subsidiaries. To create an elimination subsidiary, navigate to Setup, Company, Classifications, Subsidiaries, New. On this page, name your elimination subsidiary and make sure the elimination checkbox is checked. Once you have the appropriate hierarchy of subsidiaries, enable the feature under the Advanced Features section of the Accounting tab and Enable Features. You cannot disable this feature after enabling it. After enabling this feature, NetSuite automatically adds some things to your account. For example, your account will now have the Cumulative Translation Adjustment Elimination, CTAE, account. In addition, when you close periods, you'll notice the addition of the Eliminate Intercompany Transactions task in the task list on the Period Close checklist. Some of the fields that are added to your account include the intercompany status and paired intercompany transactions fields on sales orders, purchase orders, return authorizations, and vendor return authorization records. NetSuite will also create two records, the standard intercompany vendor form record and the standard intercompany customer form record. Next, you'll need to create intercompany accounts. These are general ledger, GL, accounts that record transactions like intercompany payments, loans, and funds transfers between subsidiaries. To create an intercompany account, navigate to Setup, Accounting, Manage GL, Chart of Accounts, New. While filling out information for the new account, select the Eliminate Intercompany Transaction box. The two types of intercompany accounts that you absolutely must set up for each subsidiary are an intercompany payable account and an intercompany receivable account. You'll need these accounts when you create your intercompany customers and vendors next. The next step is to create intercompany customers and vendors that can be used on intercompany transactions. Your intercompany customers will have the intercompany receivable account listed as their default account, and your intercompany vendors will have the intercompany payable account listed as their default account. To create an intercompany customer, navigate to Lists, Relationships, Customers, New. You may need to select a specific form, such as the standard intercompany customer form, in order to view all the necessary fields for creating an intercompany customer. On this form, name the customer, choose which subsidiary that customer belongs to in the subsidiary field, and choose which subsidiary the customer represents in the Represent Subsidiary field. Selecting a subsidiary in the Represent Subsidiary field is what designates this customer as being an intercompany customer. Under the Subsidiary subtab, you can select any subsidiaries that this customer will have transactions with. The only subsidiary you cannot select here is the subsidiary you chose in the Represent Subsidiary field. In the Default Receivables Account field under the Financial subtab, you can either choose a specific intercompany receivables account or leave this field on Use System Preferences. When Use System Preferences is selected, NetSuite uses the default account listed under the Accounting tab of the Intercompany Preferences page, Setup, Accounting, Preferences, Intercompany Preferences. You would create an intercompany vendor in essentially the same way you created an intercompany customer. Navigate to Lists, Relationships, Vendors, New. On this page, name the intercompany vendor, choose the subsidiary it belongs to, and choose the specific subsidiary it represents. Once you've listed any subsidiaries that this vendor can conduct transactions with under the Subsidiaries subtab, and once you've checked that the right intercompany payables account has been selected, save the record. When everything is set up for the NetSuite Automated Intercompany Management feature, you're ready to start creating intercompany transactions. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.